Okay, so we want all the secrets from next season.
Great. Yeah.
Yes.
Great.
You tell us. Alphabetical order, please.
Oh, well, you have to watch this season first, or else next season would make no sense.
How can you top this season?
I don't know.
That's the
challenge. That is what keeps us up at night.
But the challenge is, it's always to try to raise the bar, to try to kind of keep, you know, developing and deepening the story and taking it to new places. And that's, you know, what we push ourselves to do, and we hope to be able to continue doing that.
I heard rumors that you're looking into, and this might be just Twitter speculation, to getting Frozen characters.
There's a lot of rumors.
We were asked a question, do we like Frozen? And we said, oh my god, we love Frozen. That would be awesome. And somehow that has become a story. I mean, Darth Vader, but he's not coming on. But, you know, you never say never. It is something that we...
Yeah, look, we're fans of Frozen, we're fans of Brave, we're fans of a million Disney properties that we feel, you know, and fairy tales and stories that we feel would be great parts of the show. But, you know, what we're doing right now, you know, this season is we're really focusing on the characters you've seen and the ones we've introduced, and where we might go in the future is stuff that, you know, we're hoping to mull over and hopefully surprise
people
with.
Right. Yeah.
So we have this big showdown coming between the Wicked Witch and Regina and Emma, right? Emma's training for that right now.
Yeah.
Did we have to have the Wicked Witch be so much powerful with Regina? Can you talk about the process, why you needed those two characters to come together to fight evil?
Well, why Regina and Emma had to come together?
Right. Well, to fight the Wicked Witch.
Oh, well, for us, you know, there was a sense of the Wicked Witch, you know, you will find out, you know, she's a product of severe dark magic. And so you would need light magic to counteract that. But for us, what we really liked when we came up with the Wicked Witch is somebody that magic, she was just a natural at it. And her being so proficient in magic and Regina realizing that would kind of throw her off her game. And so, you know, what is when you think you're the best and then you find out that the person that told you were the best really didn't think you were the best, how do you come back from that?
And also, just purely, what's the fun in a villain that's easy to defeat?
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. I mean, it's we wanted to find a villain or an antagonist in the Wicked Witch who is more than a match for all of our characters, and to give her, hopefully, a really deep psychological reason for why she's doing the things she's doing, and have those things touch all of our characters and force them to have to figure out ways to battle a tougher adversary than they've ever seen before.
Okay, we're coming up on the finale. What can you tease about the rest of the season? And will Henry get his memory back?
Well, you know, the issue of Henry and his memory...
gets resolved.
Yeah, it gets resolved, and it comes to the forefront rather quickly. Within, you know, but, you know, obviously before the end of the year, and, you know, what happens with Henry is really key to what happens as the climax between our heroes and the witch.
You know, I could say is, you know, we designed this season as to be two separate seasons. So there was the Neverland, and as we said, there was a beginning, middle, and end. Mm-hmm. And so for the Wicked Witch, you know, it's the same thing. We plan to complete this season's arc so that what we set up in the beginnings of 12 episodes in the beginning, we'll finish the story by the end.
Is there any character that has gotten more time on screen based on fan reaction?
I wouldn't say that. Look, you know, we love to listen to our fans and to hear from all our fans and what they're thinking and feeling. But I think, you know...
You can, you know, when we originally wrote the pilot, you know, our idea was that Prince Charming didn't get out of the coma till episodes 3 or 4. We thought that would be a great thing to build to. And Josh was so good in the pilot that we woke him up in the next episode. So oftentimes characters will get... Like, well, it's based on excitement.
Right.
So that's a perfect example of, you know, we hadn't even aired, it was a pilot, but we were so excited about Josh and the way he portrayed this character that we started writing for
him
more.
And it's a balancing act of, like, we want the fans to be happy, we want to create a show that they appreciate and like, but we have to go with our gut. And the example Eddie just explained is a perfect example of that, where it's like, Josh was so amazing in the pilot that it kind of shifted a lot of the thinking about, you know, when the character would wake up and all that, and forced us to act in different ways. And, you know, it has to come from the gut, and you have to go with your instincts. And also, the way the show is produced, you know, with now, particularly this year where we did 11 episodes and 11 episodes, by the time we aired the first episode of the second run this year, we were writing the finale. So, you know, we really have to learn to trust our instincts and hope the fans, you know, trust them as well and go along.
Because you can't decide quickly. We don't do it live.
Right.
So if they're like, wow, we really want more of, you know, somebody, you can't just change the next week's episode because that's been locked and cut for months.
And it's, you know, and it's that thing where you really want to know what the fans think and feel and appreciate that, but you also can't, you know, right by polling.
Right.
You know, it's just...
If we listened to everything, every character would be both alive, dead, married, and single.
And there would
like, and I don't know how to do all four.
Right. Exactly. And you would have, you know, and you would be, we'd still be writing episode 102. We'd still be trying to figure out what to do based on, you know, the millions of opinions.
Mm-hmm. We found out a little bit of what happened to Hook during the year that nobody remembers.
Yes.
Are we going to get more memories back before the finale?
I think that the mystery of that missing year will be definitively resolved, you know, before the end of this year.
We're going to see a big chunk of that next week.
Yes.
In episode 19 called
A Curious Thing. This week is big.
Curious Thing.
You guys have done a really great job in taking good characters and making them not so good, taking bad characters and giving them really justifiable motivations, but not all of your bad characters, right? Pan never really came.
No.
No, we were never sympathetic to him. Are we ever going to be really sympathetic to the Wicked Witch?
Oh, that's
a great question.
You know, Pan, what we loved is at the end of the day, we wanted to create to us, anyone who wants to live 14 forever is the most selfish person in the world. And then when we knew he was Rumpel's dad, we wanted his end goal just to be self-preservation. We loved the idea of just selfishness as opposed to world domination. The Wicked Witch, you know, I think we you know, if you felt for her in episode, it's not easy being green, then you feel for her. If you think that she handled it badly, then you want her to die. So I think that your interpretation of whether or not had she had more support and love in her life, she would have gone down a different road, or...
I think as far as the witch goes, we've shown some of the past that shaped her into who she was. I think we're going to delve a bit more into her and what she's doing and why, and you know, we'll see more of that, and you know, it's really, it's up to the audience to decide whether that's sympathetic or not. But our hope...
What we can tell you is she's wicked.
Yeah, she's wicked, and a lot of our so-called evil characters or bad characters or characters who take, you know, adversity and things that happen to all of us, and they react in a different way. And hopefully you understand the reasoning behind that reaction, even if you don't condone the way they do it.
Can you talk a little bit about the decision to kill Bay?
It was, look, you know, it's not something we take lightly. Like, we love the character, we love Michael Raymond James. When you're telling a large serialized story like we're endeavoring to do, there are, you know, there are ups and downs in that story for these characters. And this was one of the most difficult things we've had to do on the show in the entire run.
Yeah, for us, we loved the idea of him when he lost Emma and Henry at the end of the first 11 and they went to New York. We loved the idea of him starting to go down the same path his father did, which was, you know, I will do anything to get with my son, no matter the cost, and then realizing that his father sacrificed himself for him, so the person that he always thought was a coward finally redeemed himself, and so Neil had to honor that, and we liked that kind of history repeating itself and then not. And unfortunately, that meant he had to die.
And you know, and I would also say this about his death, which is that, you know, the ripples of the death have not stopped being felt.
Yes.
If you can, as you continue to watch this season, you'll see that play out.
any chance August will be back anytime soon?
Not this year. But definitely. We love Ian Bailey and we love that character. So he's always on our mind.
We have, yeah. August is in our mind and how to continue to incorporate him in the show. Not this year.
How far forward are you thinking? Like, are you up two seasons from where we are now? Or how?
No, I mean,
just a few into the next?
I would say this. Like, it's, you know, if we're lucky enough to continue for however many years, we sort of attack that. We try to have a broad sense of where we would want the show to ultimately finish and end, whenever that might be. But we can really only attack it one season at a time.
Mm-hmm.
And what we try to do is plan out the entire arc of a season with the hope that there's further seasons beyond that to sort of set the pieces in place for that. But say, do we have an idea for what season 7 would be? No. Do we have an idea of where we would like the show to ultimately go? Yes.
We kind of know the last couple scenes and where we want to get to, and what we do is, in between seasons, in fact we're doing it right now, is we're planning next season. And then we all go take a little time off and come back.
Why do you think parenthood is such a strong motif in this show?
Well, I think there's no greater stakes than family, and I think family is a very universal theme, and I think the things that are interesting about fairy tales is they tell us how to live our life or be with our family or how we deal with the loss of a family member. And for us, this was always about a dysfunctional family trying to come together and get their happy ending. So for us, we just, you know, what's more emotional, you know, like if you know, Peter Pan was just some really snotty kid, at the end of the day it doesn't mean anything. But when you realize he's Rumple's father and you go back to everything that Rumple has ever done, I don't want to be a coward, I don't want to be like my dad, the fact that he let Bay go and it drove him nuts because he did to his son what he did to his father, it makes it richer than, you know, people were like, what if Bay wasn't, did Bay have to be Henry's dad and that? And it's like, well, if he was just some guy named Steve, who cares? Right? Like, think that through. Okay, he's a guy named Steve. He was, he's living in Detroit. Who cares?
You know, and it's like, and it's not to say that everybody has to be related or any of that, but it's that kind of bond, the familial bond, is so strong and so powerful that there's no greater stake for us, at least, to think about when you're writing, which is, you know, how do you interact with your family? How do you raise a family? How do you be a part of a family? Or how do you find a family? Because a family, it doesn't have to be blood. It's, you can find a family. And I think that, you know, and that's like the greatest thing you can see, you know, with characters is when they find each other and they come together and form their own family.
Well, and I think fairy tales are very ripe for that because parents are either always missing or not really great people.
Yeah,
so. Exactly.
What lies ahead for Hook and Emma?
I'm sorry, what?
Hook and Emma?
Yes.
Yeah. There's, you know, as far as Hook and Emma, like, there's, you know,
more to be told.
There's more to be told, and there's a lot of craziness going on in Storybrooke right now that they both got to deal with.
Yeah, I mean, they have, unfortunately, you know, Emma wants to go back to New York and Hook wants her to stay, so we'll see what happens.